I'm going to describe how to use an interactive simulation that models heterogeneous chemical equilibrium. This interactive simulation allows you to change various aspects of the equilibrium, the starting conditions, and see how equilibrium changes. And the simulation is located on the Wolfram site, and here's the link to the simulation. And so let me point out a few things. We can change the temperature with this slider, and that's going to shift equilibrium to the right. We can add additional calcium carbonate, calcium oxide, or carbon dioxide. And so a couple assumptions. The calcium carbonate and the calcium oxide are assumed to be in different phases. In other words, they're not mixing in the solid phase, so when we have more calcium carbonate, it doesn't change the fugacity or the activity of the calcium carbonate. So on the left, showing equilibrium, important aspect, this is a constant volume container, so the pressure changes as the temperature changes. Equilibrium pressure in this case is 37.5 bar. We have 1.5 moles of CO2 in this container. On the right, notice we have no calcium carbonate. In other words, decrease the calcium carbonate. Of course, when we do that, CO2 and calcium oxide react up to a point. The equilibrium here is such that notice we're now below the equilibrium pressure, so we can have equilibrium. It does not satisfy the equilibrium expression, which says the equilibrium constant is equal to the pressure in bar divided by 1 bar, because we don't have enough calcium oxide to reach 1.5 moles of CO2 in the gas phase. So let me point out a couple other things about the simulation. Not so clear in this figure, but as the CO2 pressure increases, the intensity of the color of the gas increases. And of course, the bar graph on the right is the number of moles, so this is a function of which volume we pick for this container. And the idea is it's only important the relative amounts, but the bar graph then helps us understand what conditions we have at equilibrium. So let's go and look at the actual simulation on the Wolfram site. So here's the simulation. You can see as I change the temperature, the pressure of carbon dioxide goes down. To the right, the gas phase in the constant volume container gets more intense as the pressure increases. And of course, I raise the temperature enough. Notice I've reacted all the calcium carbonate. If I add more calcium carbonate, then I can get the equilibrium. So now adding additional calcium carbonate has no effect on the reaction. Just like taking away calcium oxide or adding calcium oxide has no effect on the reaction, no effect on the pressure, because we're not changing anything in the equilibrium expression. We're not changing the fugacity. The activity of calcium oxide, which is a pure material, stays at 1. Now we can have finer control in these simulations. For example, I can step through the temperature, have much more control that way to pick the exact value that I want by just clicking on these show animation controls. And then for this simulation, perhaps not so useful, but we can actually do what's called auto run. And I'll slow this down a little bit. So it's stepping through, notice this, stepping through the temperature. Now it's stepping through the amount of calcium carbonate, increasing it. Notice the pressure is constant now. Once it added enough calcium carbonate to reach equilibrium, adding more has no effect. And then it'll step through calcium oxide and CO2. And so we'll close this. So you should take this simulation and use it to better understand heterogeneous equilibrium, because heterogeneous equilibrium is inherently different from when we have gas phase components on both sides and we can reach equilibrium by lowering the pressure of one of the components. Here, because we have solids that don't mix, it's an all or nothing situation. If we have any calcium carbonate, it has an activity of 1. It's a fixed fugacity. And then we have none, we can no longer satisfy the equilibrium expression.